The PAMP attack.
During the long run of Republican leadership prior to the Great Depression, corporate America and the Republicans had an agreement. Government would not regulate and business would not be limited by checks and balances. Corporations were able to generate bigger profits at the expense of workers, consumers, the U.S. Treasury, and the U.S. economy. The big were gobbled up by the bigger, and the concept of arm's-length competition was illusory. Deregulation increased profits, but none of those profits trickled down to the workers. It was laissez-faire government at its very worst. Myths were created about corporations and capitalism. A few of those myths were that a publicly held corporation has no duty to the public except to maximize profit for their shareholders. In other words, ignore the fact that the corporation could never exist without the roads, without the law enforcement, our court systems, and military that taxpayers provide the corporation so it can do business. That myth ignored billions of dollars the public spends every year on research and development that taxpayers dish out at universities through medical research, military research, agricultural research, and hundreds of other areas that corporations benefit from where it comes to research. 14 years of deregulation has been profitable for big business, but not for the average American. In this same time of unregulated modern robber barons, for every $500 a corporate CEO makes, a worker makes $1. The average annual salary for a top corporate CEO is $15 million, while the average median income for a U.S. household has fallen by $1,000 since 2001. Listen carefully to the latest talking points from Mitch McConnell or Paul Ryan or John Boehner, and you're going to hear him telling you that more corporate freedom to do whatever the hell that corporation wants to do is good for America, that it's good for capitalism. Why would they still be trying to sell these disastrous ideas? Well, it's because most Americans still don't understand why they lost their homes. They don't understand why they lost their jobs or why there are no longer members of the America's so-called middle class. Most Americans whose lives are in shambles have never stopped to figure out just how badly the Republican corporation machine has trampled on them. It's almost like they don't care. To some degree, that's their fault. It's their fault because they never fought back. Many of them still don't ask questions. So this entire election cycle that's coming up, we're going to see mega corporations spend billions of dollars selling that same old worn out failed theme to low information voters who don't care, who still don't have the good sense to figure out what the hell happened to them the last time the Republicans let corporations dominate American politics. More than 1 million families have lost their homes to foreclosure because GOP government drank the Kool-Aid served up by the financial industry. That industry told Congress that if Congress would trim regulations, the financial industry would show how responsible they could be. So they showed us. Everything in business and government flows from the top. For example, Exxon, Halliburton, Countrywide, and Citicorp are at the top of the food chain in the business world. They have one thing in common. It is that their corporation is not designed with a conscience or a sense of fairness. In fact, it could be argued that their corporation is commanded not to operate with those qualities if it's going to cost their shareholders even a penny. So when fair dealing clashes with corporate profits, those profits will always endure. But in order to live, a corporation needs to thrive in a political system that it can control. So it gobbles up characters that it would ordinarily have the luxury to ignore. The Tom DeLays, the Karl Roves, and the Dick Cheneys of politics. And in turn, in order for those political culprits to prosper, they've got to adapt their political policies to please their corporate sponsors. It all flows from the top, but the top is not America's government. The top is a collection of corporate types that abhor anything that looks like a check and a balance regulation. The top is Wall Street, not the White House, where today we see Wall Street determining what the price of gasoline is going to be by way of unregulated crude oil speculation. Wall Street is where it's determined whether a small family business gets a loan or whether big box stores are going to gobble up mom and pop businesses. Wall Street will consistently determine who our president's going to be, who's going to sit in our Supreme Court, who will go to war with us, or who we'll go to war with. The top is Wall Street, UBS, AT&T, Shell Oil, and every other mega corporation beholden to its shareholders.